patrol ship. Designation, Hallis Hope.
Did you say Hallis Hope?
there's a thing I gotta do. I'll be right back.
We need to get rid of that animal. Now. I'm serious, Peter. If it stays on the ship, we all go to prison.
No one's going to jail. It's a harmless space llama thingy.
Harmless? Remember Inukubi?
Not really, no.
That's because they scorched the planet because an idiot smuggled in an Exelon.
I will eject the beast into space.
Whoa, 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 whoa. We're not ejecting anything. It'll make us look guilty.
It could be carrying Zephron's disease.
Which is why Drax is going to hide in the secret cargo compartment behind Groot's plants.
Peter Jason Quill.
Really? My middle name? Hey, Krell! How you doing? How long's it been? 2-3 years? You look good. You been tanning?
This is a new low, Peter. Even for you.
Corral, I swear it's not what it looks like.
That you're a junker trespassing in the most restricted area of space? Who consorts with thieves and murderers, apparently.
Hey, killing people for money ain't murder, lady.
Come on, Corral. You know me. We've been to hell and back. Sure, I've done some shady stuff since the war. Like, really shady stuff. But junking?
I just caught you pink-handed. Leaving the quarantine zone.
Technically, yes, but we weren't scavenging.
Right.
Peter Quill, I found these items in the space that you told me about. There was not enough room for both the other thing and these.
Peter Quill, of planet C-53, under galactic law ZXB-47, I am putting you and your crew under arrest for...
Actually, can I call you back?
What?
Please tell me that is not a crate of super illegal tech.
It is a crate of super illegal tech, which also happens to be very valuable.
Really?
What? We're on a Ravager ship. Even the Flarkin bulkheads are stolen.
Well, we can't fit both in the compartment.
I will eject the crate into space.
Eject the crate and I melt your face! The Milano's weapon systems are 4 generations behind, Quill. We need that tech, more than we need some stupid farm animal.
That farm animal could be a Class 3 biohazard. You want to end up in the kiln?
Hide the llama.
What? What about my stuff?
Rocket, I know Corral. I'm pretty sure I can get her to go easy on us about the tech, but a potential biohazard? Man, I'm good, but I'm not that good.
You slept with a cop?
She wasn't a cop at the time. The point is, we were close. You just have to trust me.
I am Groot.
And that would be your boarding party.
Silence, prisoner. No time to meet with law-breaking pirates like you.
That's just it. We're not pirates. We're Lee Incorporated heroes for hire.
Yeah, that's right. You check those records, Buckethead. Novacore licensing permit 67398-2.
Gardeners of the Galaxy?
What? No. Rocket.
So I let Groot fill out the paperwork. I fixed it with an addendum.
Not the most well-known heroes you could hire, but definitely in the top 5 of most awesome names. Contributing members. Groot, a Flora Colossus. Last of his kind, fearless in a firefight, an awesome best friend. Rocket, bona fide super genius and a wizard with explosives. Definitely not a raccoon. Gamora. Adopted daughter of Thanos, deadliest woman in the galaxy. Need we say more? Drax the Destroyer, convicted serial murderer and galactic war hero, often grumpy. Last and definitely least, Peter Jason Quill.
That's it? That's all you wrote?
There was a character limitation.
Sorry, excuse me, I just need to...
Cadet Gold, what are you doing here?
Oh, you don't know? Really? It says right here. Prisoner processing training. I'm your official trainee.
Aren't you a little young for the Corps?
Aren't you a little old for that hairdo?
I should check with the captain.
No. She definitely signed off on this. You know how thorough she is about signing stuff? If I may, sir, the real concern here is Regulation 7A regarding prisoner footgear. That one's jet boots are in clear violation.
They're decorative.
Good work, Cadet Gold.
Great. There goes Plan B.
We don't need a Plan B. I got this.
No, you do not got this, pirate. I got this. Now fall in line.
Time to go, prisoners.
Watch the jacket.
Cadet Gold, you know the arrest protocols?
All memorized, sir. First thing we do...
We're not hunting an illegal creature in illegal space.
There's so much wrong with this arrest. A, no way a kid should be here.
I'm an official trainee.
And B, I'm very, very close friends with the captain.
Hold it right here. Is there a problem?
Yes! No faith energy, no power. No power, no containment. A single spot.
The techs are looking at it. They say that.
They cannot even fathom. How can they fix what they cannot understand?
Put the Grand Unifier's mind at ease. Run the scanners again.
What the flark is a Grand Unifier?
Grand Unifier Raker. Leader of the Church of Universal something. He was floating dead in the quarantine zone. Looking for God.
All right, pirates. Let's go.
We caught him just like we caught you.
Difference is, I know the captain. As I was saying, if you just tell the captain that I...
Mom explicitly said she doesn't want to see you.
Yeah, well...
Just to be super clear on the mom thing...
Hold on!
Quill!
Peter!
Hold on to something, Quill!
No!
Hey, kiddo, you there? Nova girl!
Yeah. I think so. Let me just see if I can...
Hold on! Wish I... had my... jet boots!
Get that gold, was it?
Nikki?
Oh, it's nice to meet you, Nikki.
Okay, Nikki, here's the plan. You're gonna jump and grab my legs while I hold on for dear life.
That doesn't sound like...
Trust me, kiddo. We got this. See? This isn't weird at all. Doing great.
Okay. That was kind of amazing, huh?
Whoa! Thanks.
Yeah, Mom wouldn't be impressed if I lost my first prisoner.
Your mom, right?
Come on. We need to get out of here. There's a blast door around the corner. We'll be safe there. Here. Help me with this. Ready?
Together. On 3, 2, 1.
Go! Okay.
We need to keep moving. This way.
You dead, Nikki?
Whoa.
Just stay close.
I knew there was something wrong about that church. Who goes fishing for God in a junkyard?
Oh, man. This is bad.
Pretty sure I can override them with my passkey.
They give out override keys to trainees?
Not exactly. Just give me a sec. Come on.
You know, I could probably help with the door if we undid these cuffs.
Regulation 3B. Never undo restraints.
Come on. You clearly need my help.
No. You're my prisoner. And I got this.
Obviously.
Okay, we're gonna have to find another way.
We sure there isn't a way through here?
I'm in
Whoa! You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. You?
Oh, dandy.
Okay, this way.
Shouldn't we be going up? Back toward the others?
There's another blast door down here.
Can't we establish your special key thing?
Whoa!
Are you kidding me?
Relax, you're fine-ish.
I mentioned how useful my jet boots will be right now.
Okay, I can do this.
Not to rush you or anything.
Almost there. Yes! Got it! Through here.
Whew! Nice work.
Thanks. You didn't do too bad yourself, pirate.
Only Star-Lord. Or Peter, or, you know, Nova Cadet Butt-Saver.
Okay. Peter. So, listen. I have some good news, and some bad news about your friends. Did you hear me? I said—
Give me the good news.
They're all fine. I mean, they all have life lines.
So, what's the bad news?
They've been processed and put in the brig. In case you thought the explosion could give them a chance to escape or something.
Hey, we're innocent, remember? No need to escape when you're innocent.
Come on. We'll be safe through here. Flark! First.
Should we try using that thingamajig of yours to call someone?
We don't need help. I know what I'm doing. Now help me block this fire so we can get through.
Sure. Just that everyone must be worried. Captain's kid goes missing. Easy does it.
There, see? You don't need to worry about me. Enough people around here do that already.
Look, as the adult in the room...
Yeah, adult isn't exactly how my mom described you.
How did Carell describe me? Is that robot wearing makeup?
What? Oh, yeah. That's just it. I know all the bots down here. They're kind of my friends, I guess. I reprogrammed most of them.
And gave them faces.
Maybe.
No, I mean it's cool. Give them a personality. Very cool.
Come on, this way.
So, we're agreed that you owe me one, right?
Okay, wow. Just blatantly gonna ignore me and go crawling into a dead end. Regulation 2B. Prisoners must stay close at all times.
Really got them all memorized, don't you? Does your mom know you play down here?
Probably not. But what else am I gonna do? Not like there's any other kids on board.
You know, I didn't have a lot of friends at your age either. Granted, I was in prison, but still.
So Mom was right about you.
It was a Chitauri prison. I was just a kid.
I have so many questions. Were your parents in prison too?
No, my mom, died. I didn't know my dad.
How do you know my mom, exactly?
We fought together on Mercury during the war. She was, is a real spitfire.
More like real controlling. And bossy, and judgmental. You're just a kid, Nikki. You don't know what's good for you, Nikki. Stay out of the escape pods, Nikki.
Pretty sure all kids get annoyed with their moms. But, as you get older, you realize they're right more often than not.
Ugh, whatever. Okay, almost there.
Almost where?
You'll see. Going.
Just making sure this place is safe and secure from the, you know, fire.
This way. Any day now.
Right, right, just...
I'm still in charge, you know. It's a dead end. Trust me.
Of course I trust you. This another one of your bots?
Yeah, her name's Jocasto. She keeps an eye out for stuff. Invaders. Sirs. Prisoners who keep wandering off. Quick reminder that only one of us
knows the way out.
Could have fooled me. If this is an attempt to escape your mom's ship, I really need to know, because I may or may not be super interested. Just really need to make sure it doesn't look like a kidnapping.
What? No, no!
Oh, wow!
Don't laugh.
No, no! This is cool. It's like your secret hideout, right? I definitely prefer this to the brig.
I just need to check on Ultimo. His gyros have been all screwy.
Take your time. Is this your mom? Single-handedly winning the war?
Obviously, I know she didn't do it by herself.
No. That final push was, it was a massive team effort.
Were you there?
I contributed to the war effort differently.
Pirating?
Raiding, which is, you know, the good kind of pirating. Is this Krelar?
Yeah. Long time ago. Kid stuff. I could do it way better. Oh.
No, no, it's good. Morbid, but good. Hey, this is Mercury, right?
Uh-huh. It's supposed to represent this big battle Mom was part of. You said you were there, right?
Oh, yeah. Your mom was dead in the water until me and the Ravager showed up. You should really fix this.
You want me to draw you in?
In the interest of historical accuracy. Universal translator. Wonder if it speaks Groot. Something tells me you and Rocket would get along. Or really, really not get along. One of those two.
The raccoon thing? Yeah, he seemed real charming.
I just mean he's also really into all this tech stuff. Need a hand?
Nope. But thanks. I'm almost done. Hey! Secret stuff! Off limits!
No adults. I get it.
Anyway, I'm all done here. We should probably get back before Mom completely freaks.
Yeah, I've seen your mom overreact before.
It's like, I'm not a kid anymore, you know?
Tell me about it.
So, you get where I'm coming from, right? Like, if you do end up talking to my mom, the subject of me happens to come up. Because the truth is, I wasn't exactly supposed to...
Say no more. I'll make sure Corell knows what a good job you did.
No! I mean, thanks, but...
Ideally, Mom never needs to know I was in the hangar at all.
So I... never saw you?
Exactly! Never saw her. Never saw my past me. Heard of me. How cool she is, but... Almost at the elevator. We're home free. Seriously?
Just get me.
Come on, come on! Ah! Ugh, are you kidding me?
Need a hand?
Yes! Got it! Mom? I can explain. Nikki. I'm fine. Mom, seriously. A-okay. Barely a scratch.
What in Hala's name were you thinking? Sneaking out with an arresting squad. Running around with criminals.
Alleged criminals.
You almost died. Do you have any idea how grounded you are right now?
Mom! You promised to give me more leeway.
Leeway doesn't mean lying to my officers. Or sneaking around behind my back.
Like it's my fault some guy's ship blew up?
Restricted areas are restricted for a reason.
You treat me like a prisoner!
You're a child! Are you even listening?
Whoa, whoa! We've all been through a lot today. Let's just all take a deep breath and recognize that maybe we've all made some mistakes.
Make sure the fire is out and the hangar's secure.
Yes, Commander.
And find out why that Churchman's shuttle exploded.
Grand Unifier Raker has been less than cooperative.
Make him cooperate. And you two, with me.
I knew you'd overreact. You always overreact. Even Peter was saying so.
Oh, he was he? I suspect Peter misspoke, something he often tends to do. So I suggest you worry less about what he said and more about what I'm saying now. What you did was extremely dangerous.
For what it's worth, Nikki totally saved my butt. She handled herself really well. You have every reason to be proud of her.
Coming from you, Peter, it's worth extraordinarily little.
Why are you being mean to him? Just listen to what he's saying.
I don't care what he's saying.
Upper level. Captain's quarters.
Fine. Initiate lockdown.
Lockdown initiated.
What, are you gonna kill us?
In theory, these doors don't open until I say so.
Yeah, I know how lockdown works.
I don't think you do, because somehow you keep bypassing every security measure on this ship, and I want to know how. Or you can just show me.
Mom! I seriously have no idea what you're talking about. Isn't this, like, against galactic law or something?
You know, this reminds me of the last time I was stuck in an elevator. I was with this Shi'ar girl, and she...
Ew! What is wrong with you?
She was a lovely person.
Someone, please get me out of here.
No one leaves until you tell me what I want to know.
You already know everything!
No, I don't. I know you're a magnet for danger, and that you somehow keep getting caught in restricted areas of this ship.
I'm small. Okay? I fit into places.
Being small doesn't get you past security, or through the hangar bay checkpoint, or the maintenance tunnel blast doors, or even into the sub-level I just found you in. So...
There was that system-wide glitch, remember?
Yeah. Yeah, security was down for a while.
No, it wasn't.
Seemed pretty down to me.
Are you seriously lying for a 12-year-old right now?
12? Oh, wow, I thought she was at least 16.
Peter!
What? She really knew her stuff. She's a smart kid.
Too smart. She keeps bypassing security. Unless you have a level 6 access to my ship all of a sudden? Didn't think so. Nicolette Gold, empty your pockets.
No. You empty your pockets.
Nikki?
What?
I know you're hiding something.
I'm not.
It was me. Yeah, all those locked doors back there, I hacked them.
You hacked them?
Yeah, I'm a hacker now. I hack stuff. You know, beep, bop, boop. Boop, boop, beep.
I told him it was restricted.
That doesn't explain the falsified orders.
I don't know what to tell you, Mom. Your security staff have been sleeping on the job. All I know is I'm not hiding anything. I wouldn't do that.
To be continued. Disengage lockdown.
So, can I go help secure the hangar now?
No, you can go back to your quarters and you can stay there for the next 30 rotations.
But Mom!
I can make it 30 cycles.
So, rough day, huh? Exploding shuttles, quarantine zone trespassers, missing kid.
I have no idea.
Chewie. I can't believe you still have him. Can't believe you survived. Mercury was what, like 1,000 degrees?
More like 1,000 cycles ago. You can keep him if you want. He is yours.
Hey, I ordered him to look out for you. Expect him to keep doing his job. Especially, you now have a daughter, apparently. A 12-year-old daughter, who you didn't have during the war. 12 years ago, when we...
Peter. When we picked up your ship, part of me was excited. At first. But then after all this time, you haven't changed. At all. You're still the same...
I've changed. Whatever the fine is, I'll pay. Just give me 3 cycles. Let me prove that I'm not still... whatever it is you're gonna finish that sentence with.
You're gonna pay 7,000 units? In 3 cycles?
Wow, okay, that is a lot of money. Here, I was thinking that maybe...
The fine's non-negotiable. My search party found a disturbing amount of prohibited tech lying around your ship.
Well, that's all they found, right? Okay, you'll get your money on time, no problem. This Guardians of the Galaxy thing, we are this close to getting it off the ground. And if I didn't have these handcuffs on, I would show you just how very close we are.
Why do I feel like I'll regret this?
Oh, come on. When have I ever... You won't regret it. Promise.
You've got 3 cycles, Peter. Not 4, not 5, 3. Contact me when you've got the units.
And if we don't?
The device we installed will deactivate your ship, and you will all go to prison.
Gotcha. We won't let you down.
What the hell, Peter? You said you could get us out of this.
I did. 7,000 units is a small price.
7,000 units?
That is a tremendous sum.
Where are we gonna get that kind of money in 3 cycles?
By robbing a freaking bank, apparently.
Okay! So we got fined. So we have a Nova tracking thing on our ship that's gonna shut down our engines if we don't pay that fine in 3 cycles. At least we're not on a prisoner transport.
Not yet.
Come on, guys. You're Drax the Destroyer, man. You killed Thanos.
Allegedly.
Are you gonna let a little fine slow you down? And Gamora, you're practically an MI6 agent, but way hotter and cooler. There's nothing you can't do.
Here it comes.
Rocky, you're an actual genius and the scrappiest dude I know. How many prisons did you break out of?
7.
I'm Groot.
You are Groot. Guys, we're supposed to be a team. All we need to do is figure out how broke we are and come up with a plan. So check your quarters. Check between the sofa cushions. Check under the crafting bench. If you find any spare units lying around, grab them. I'll do the same in my quarters.
All right.
This is why you don't sleep with cops, Quill. They put bombs on my ship.
My ship.
I am watching you, rodent.
What's that supposed to mean?
It is common knowledge that rodents hoard. Nuts, stolen technology, units. Peter Quill, tell the rodent that his selfishness endangers us all.
Rocket, we could really use any extra units you have.
How do I gotta spell it out for you? I don't got no units!
Fair enough.
You believe his lies?
Oh, I ain't lying. Now why don't you leave me alone and bother someone else instead?
I intend to.
What do you want, Quill? If you're looking for units, check your own room. So, you here to talk, or you just want a gear upgrade?
You're not still upset, are you?
It'd be a lot better if we didn't have 3 cycles to pay a fine.
Hey, remember that time on Conlar? With the Badoon and that really hot Ascavarian girl?
Yeah, her buddies would have spaced your stupid Humi butt if me and Groot hadn't busted in.
I had things under control, mostly.
Ha! Too bad you're broke, Quill. I should be charging you for all the times we saved you.
Name one other time you saved me.
Contraxia, Nowhere, Parameter, Ceres, Contraxia again, Malador...
Okay, so I owe you. Big.
I should have turned you in for Yondu's bounty. Sure as Scott wouldn't be scrounging for units to pay off your Nova girlfriend.
Ex-girlfriend. But admit it, you like being a Guardian of the Galaxy.
Still on the fence about the brand name, but keeping the Milano as collateral was a pretty smart move.
Never agreed to that.
If you'd rather, I turn you in.
Don't worry. I know you put a lot into this team. I'll make it up to you.
You better.
Open this door! I know you are in there, sentient tree! Do not think that I do not know what you are up to. Your rodent co-conspirator has clearly stashed his illicit units in there.
I am Groot.
Peter Quill, order the tree to open this door. I am certain that the rodent has hidden a stash of units within the latrine. He must have asked his well-meaning accomplice to retrieve the sum and hide it from us.
All right. I'll check on him and tell you if he's doing anything weird.
Acceptable.
Groot? You okay in there? Think you could open the door for a minute? Is that my toothbrush? Great. Now I need a new toothbrush.
Any units I uncover will go directly to you, but I am unsure the others will do the same.
So, you're taking the whole find the units thing pretty seriously.
It is a serious matter.
Yeah, I totally get it. We're all afraid of going back to prison.
I am not afraid of going back to prison.
Oh, good. Because I'm not either, mostly.
In the kiln, I was surrounded by criminals, murderers, and thieves. They taught me a harsh lesson. Assassins and bounty hunters cannot be trusted.
Okay. Wow. Don't you think maybe you're calling the kettle black?
I have not mentioned kitchenware.
It's an Earth thing. What I mean is, you're a convicted mass murderer. I used to be a pirate. We're not exactly upstanding citizens.
You and I honor our word. I cannot say the same for the others.
You could be wrong, Drax. You won't know until you give them a chance.
We will see.
Hey, Gamora.
You're supposed to knock.
What are you doing? You're supposed to be looking for money.
I did.
And?
I don't have any.
Also, what's with the dolls?
Do you value your life?
Is that a trick question? Okay, yes, mostly I value my life.
Good. Then pretend like you saw nothing and get out.
See you in the lounge?
Out.
Got it.
So, Drax, did you bring out your stash of hidden units?
I do not hide my units.
Neither am I.
You are rodent-like.
And you're annoying-like.
That is not a valid taxonomic order.
Guys, don't forget to close the fridge!
Sure thing, Mom Lord. Groot, are you done in there? Me and Musclehead could use some input. What do you mean, a minute? You've been in there for ages.
I have noticed that the tree is very meticulous about grooming.
I don't go into your room and touch your stuff, Quill.
What? You hacked my visor and added a scoreboard to it while I was sleeping.
That was different. I improved it. Also, did anyone tell you that you snore? I thought Drax was bad, but wow. Quill. You should really get that checked. You sound like a Torg.
I don't snore that loud.
Yeah, okay.
So what is this thing anyway? It kind of looks like a metal face hugger.
That is clearly a spinal control unit.
Yes, right, of course, a spinal control thingy.
Back on Half-World, Kree scientists use these to keep us super soldiers in line. They'd press a big, fun red button and zap! Instant obedience.
Holy crap. Rocket. What exactly did the Kree do to you?
They ripped me apart and rebuilt me over and over and over again until I became this half-finished thing they could mold and shape and control.
Oh, Rocket, I had no idea. I mean, I knew the Kree Empire was desperate, but...
Do you know what it's like to lose all control of your body? To be in constant pain, trapped inside yourself, unable to stop the horrible things you're doing? That control unit made sure I did what I was supposed to do. Oh yeah, whether I wanted to or not. A neat, furry little machine of death. Didn't take long to figure out I was better off not fighting it.
Okay, then let's shoot this thing out the airlock. Have a little middle finger salute ceremony to the bastards who built it.
I don't think I'm ready to let go of that part of me yet. Maybe one day.
Are you 100% sure you want to keep it? What if it...
controls me? I decided a long time ago, Quill, that I would never let anyone control me again. As far as I'm concerned, this is just another useful piece of junk and a few bad memories.
How many of you super soldiers were there on Half-World?
When the Kree started, 100, maybe. By the time I escaped, just me and Lila. She was the first one not to die from the control unit.
And Lila is also a...
what? A raccoon?
Or not a raccoon?
You gotta understand. She was afraid of them, and the control unit made sure we stayed in line. That I stayed in line.
Oh, that sounds... awful. I can't imagine.
So, I did what I do best. I found a way to overload the control unit. When the Blueskins let us out of our cage, kaboom! I blew a hole into the side of the lab. What we didn't know, what I didn't know, was that the lab was protected by sentry bots. We got to the security fence and Lila covered me while I hacked the modulator frequency and as soon as it opened, she pushed me through the door. I heard a Dyquil.
Oh, Rocket.
Doesn't matter now. Past is the past, right? And that thing, it's just a reminder.
I'm sorry you had to go through all that, Rocket. For real.
Let me guess. You're watching me.
I am.
What do you think I'm gonna do? Conjure some units from thin air?
Can you do that?
No! Why you gotta be so paranoid, big guy? You didn't mind trusting me on Hanchi.
Trust you repaid by attempting to rob our employer.
I told you, I was just testing their security measures.
So you claimed.
Hey, Bluebird, you copy? I know you think I sold you out, and... Gamora, I was just...
Who are you talking to? What's a Bluebird?
It, was Yondu's call sign. He was Bluebird and I was the kid.
Let me get this straight. Yondu Udonta, leader of the Ravagers space virus, scourge of the Sirius system and all-around scoundrel, used Bluebird as his call sign?
Even had it embroidered on the back of his jacket.
Amazing.
It was amazing. Pretty much from the day we met.
How did you two meet? Terrans and Centaurians aren't exactly neighbors.
We met on Chitauri Prime. About 3 years into my sentence.
Wait. Yondu was a prisoner of war? I thought the Ravagers were neutral.
They were. And they also weren't. Yondu and I were cellmates. First thing he said when they put him in my cell was, "Boy, don't be going and getting attached, because I'm just here for the food." And the food was pretty terrible, so...
Yeah, that sounds like Yondu.
I had cellmates before, and none of them lasted long. The Chitauri have these gladiatorial games, and...
You got used to people dying.
Not sure about that, but I didn't expect anyone to last long. I also didn't have my translation implant back then, so I might as well have been alone. But Yondu, he actually spoke English. Said he'd offered to translate in exchange for extra rations.
So even in the snake-infested hellhole, ever the schemer.
It's something we had in common. I've been scheming for a way to escape since the day they took me. I just needed someone like Yondu to make it seem possible.
How did you escape?
Let's just say it was equal parts simple, complicated, and kind of embarrassing. But it ended with the two of us delivering a transport full of stolen supplies straight into the hands of the Resistance.
For a bucket-load of units, too, I bet.
Anyway, once we did, there was no going back. I was a Ravager. The Ravagers had a simple code. Steal from everyone. Yondu said it made them neutral.
But they weren't. I specifically remember several Chitauri transports being hit when I was still... you know.
They hit just as many Resistance ships. Until a Chitauri cruiser uncloaked in front of them during a raid and...
Yondu ended up on Chitauri Prime. With you.
Mm-hmm. After we broke out, he could have left me on some space station or dropped me off at the nearest Nova Corps base. But he didn't. Instead, he invited me to join the Ravagers.
You were with them a long time. Must have enjoyed it.
I did. Being a Ravager was the first time I felt like I really belonged. If that makes any sense.
I felt the same way when I joined Richard Ryder and the Resistance. Like I was finally in control of who I wanted to be.
Yes, exactly. Those first few years, it was like I had joined this really big, really dysfunctional family, which, now that I'm hearing it, would make Yondu my...
Space dad?
Could have been worse. Well, if you don't mind, I think I'd like to be alone for a bit.
Oh, yeah, sure. I'll see you around.
Well, well, well. Let's see if we can find some stray units in here. Really?
units?
We appear to be 6,963 units short. If we intend to keep our ship, Peter Quill...
I know. We clearly need a plan.
And reconsider my initial proposal.
Oh, no, not Fin Fang Foom again.
Yes, we should go after Fin Fang Foom.
Drax, there are easier ways to get paid. Like, what about selling Gamora's crap?
What?
Oh, come on, you've been hoarding them stupid knickknacks ever since you first joined us. I mean, don't tell me they ain't worth nothing.
The quarantine zone was always
holding out on
my figurines are not knickknacks.
Huh, team's in trouble, and you can't be bothered to make no sacrifice.
Set course for the
I will sacrifice
system.
Your head.
And take us to the majestic mountains
yeah,
of Kakaran.
Real mature.
We will seek to best the
I
infamous Finn.
At least I got an idea.
I am Groot. I am Groot.
He says we should combine both ideas.
Sell Gamora's trinkets to Fin Fang Foom. It is brilliant.
Yeah, you know, the only problem with your plan is that Lady Hellbender only buys monsters, and you are not a monster. He's not. He's the sweetest, most...
I am Groot.
No, you don't. This ain't something you can pretend.
I am Groot.
Oh, yeah? You want monster? I'll show you monster!
Whoa, guys!
Groot, are you really offering to-
No, he is not offering that, okay?
It could work.
Sell Groot? I guess we could bust him out after.
Absurd. Lady Hellbender seeks the monster within. The small, ugly one is clearly the correct choice. He's cruel, sadistic, and his soul is filthy and filled with rage. Monster Queen would pay a great sum for such a creature.
Really?
How great?
How are you okay with this?
Because I know what I am. And I know what he ain't.
I am Groot.
I vote we sell Groot. I honestly think Lady Hellbender will go for it.
Yeah, well, I vote for not Groot.
I also vote for the creepy little beast.
2 votes each. Peter?
Well, Rocket's definitely scarier on the inside. He's unstable and vicious and totally oblivious to the needs of others.
Okay, we get it, Quill.
The point is I think you'd make a fine monster. And we'll definitely need that tactical brain of yours to bust you out once you're in there. But just to be 100% sure, you're definitely okay with this.
Are you kidding? I can't wait to hold this over you.
All right, let's do this. Let's go sell a monster.
We're not seriously flying into that.
You say the weather patterns of Sekhnarf 9 are tied to the temperament of its ruler.
That's not how women work.
Or weather. Anyways, I'm sure it looks worse than it is.
Get us in close, Quill. I don't want to walk in this.
Whoa! Yep, no problem. We're flying the wrong way.
Nah, he's not flying at all.
Guys, relax. Just one minor adjustment.
Piece of cake.
You can't be serious.
What? This way we can scope things out before we finish the transaction.
We're like 100 clicks from her base.
You know how much I like scoping. Nope. Okay.
Next time, I'm flying.
Monsters do not fly ships.
Monsters do whatever they want.
I am...
Don't you get all gloomy right now. It don't help.
Because your constant complaining does.
You are complaining about the shortcut. We're all complaining. Happy?
Ugh, Groot. Why? Looks broken. Maybe Rocket can fix it. Groot! Hey, buddy. I was just, checking to see if everything was okay. And it is. Okay.
I am Groot.
Too bad this translator's busted. I was hoping it might have Groot stored on it, or something.
I am Groot.
That way I could download it into my translator. I'd love to know what your thoughts are on stuff without, you know, Rocket always filtering it.
I am Groot.
Actually, hold that thought. Yo, Rocket!
What?
Can you come here for a sec?
What do you want, Quill? I'm busy.
Think you can see if this translator has Groot's language on it?
It doesn't.
You didn't even check.
Don't need to. Cheap scut like that don't have rare language packages. And even if it did, it's beyond salvageable.
Really? Wait, do you have Groot's language package installed in your translation implant?
Do I look like I'm made of units? Only folks who got that language package are rich people.
So you actually speak Groot then?
You mean Telinizen? And yeah, I speak it, more or less. Me and Groot been bounty hunting together for a decade before you came along, Quill. When you've been working together that long, you develop a common understanding.
I am Groot.
You say misunderstandings, I say open to interpretation.
I am Groot.
They didn't go sour. We didn't need those jobs anyway.
So you guys learned to understand each other over time.
And with the help of a spreadsheet of Groot's lexicon, which ain't no easy feat when your entire language sounds like I am in Groot.
So there's hope for us yet.
I am Groot.
You know, I didn't always have a translation implant. I mean, I was failing Spanish before I left Earth, not that Spanish would have prepared me for all of this.
I'm Groot.
Man, those first few years, do you know how hard it was to get by without having any idea what people were saying? Half of the languages out here sound like white noise, weird birds, and messed up theremins. I don't even want to know what Rocket actually sounds like. TV did not prepare me for the realities of living in space, let me tell you.
I'm Groot.
Honestly, man, you're lucky you have Rocket. I mean, I know what it's like to be surrounded by people and have no one understand you, how lonely that can be. I'd have been lost. You must have been lost, too, before Rocket and us.
I am Groot.
I probably don't say this enough, but you really are an important part of the team. I can't imagine the Guardians of the Galaxy without Groot. And who knows, if this thing does have your language in it and Rocket can download it somehow or hack it or, I don't know.
I am Groot.
It'd be nice to finally talk to you. For real. Glad we had this little chat.
I am Groot.
Awesome. Cool.
That's how many times I've had to deny being a shapeshifter before Drax moved on to something else.
I still have my doubts. It is not possible for you to slip into combat.
So we need units. What about selling that llama beast?
Lady Hellbender would never purchase such a lowly creature.
Not to Lady Hellbender, obviously, but what about the Nowhere Market?
I'm not sure we'd even get 20 units out of it. Now, if we'd still have my weapon stash, though...
We could have sold the weaponry.
No! If we still had my stash, we could have upgraded the Milano's weapon system and blasted Novacore out of the sky!
Doubtful.
Let him dream. Hope that jacket of yours is waterproof.
No, we should not go. We gotta. It's different.
Of course, it had to be raining.
They say that Sektnarf 9 is inhospitable to soft-bodied beings. We should see how you fare, Peter Quill.